Imagine this. You wake up to the sound of raging waters. The street outside your window, which was familiar and safe, is now a river. This isn't some disaster movie where the Rock shows up in a helicopter to save you. The world's getting its feet wet, literally. Today we have flood defenses such as dikes, dams, and canals. Still, we have high waters. The tension between human development and the natural world is intensifying. Why do floods happen? It's a combination of things. Heavy rainfall, melting snow, deciding to join forces and overflow rivers. Storms and a rising sea level can cause trouble from the sea. Put it all together, what do you get? A wet mess. Your house and stuff will be damaged. When your house is flooded, you should go to the roof or go as high as possible. Years ago, the sea level was 120 meters lower than it is now because there were more ice and land bridges. During warmer periods, the sea was 30 meters higher than its current level. The main difference today is that changes in sea level are caused by both natural processes and human activities. Did you know that in the last decade, flood-related disasters increased by over 50% worldwide? Factors like climate change, which is heating up the planet, deforestation, which is causing the water not to be absorbed, and unchecked urban development, which is preventing water to go into the ground. These things are turning floods into a reoccurring nightmare. The Netherlands has waged a centuries-long battle against water. Without the protection of barriers, 60% of the country would regularly be underwater. This isn't just any land, it's prime real estate where 9 million people live and where they make 70% of their GDP, which is a fancy way of saying a heck of a lot of money. Every year, meltwater from the Alps swells as rivers, while summer storms elevate sea levels. Despite these challenges, the Netherlands has developed effective prevention methods to safeguard its land and people. How do we prevent sea-related flooding? Firstly, we have dikes and levees. These long raised barriers constructed along the coastline serve against seawater flooding inland. They've stood the test of time as one of the most traditional and effective means of sea flood prevention. Storm surge barriers are impressive structures, like the Muiskantkering in the Netherlands. It can be closed during storm events and remain open to allow for a free flow of water and ships. Seawalls and beach nourishment are built along the coast. By adding sand or sediment to beaches, we can combat erosion and provide a buffer zone to absorb wave energy before it can impact the coast or inland areas. Floodplain restoration is another solution. By restoring floodplains along the coast, we provide additional space for water to spread out during high tide or storm surges, reducing the risk of flooding in populated areas. Tidal barriers, constructed across the mouth of the river, control the flow of water and protect against high tide and storm surges. From the implementation of zoning and land use planning to climate change mitigation strategies, there are numerous ways to prevent sea-related flooding. How crucial are flood management strategies in preserving our environment or safeguarding our communities? How do we prevent floods from our rivers and rainfall? First on our list are dams and reservoirs. These structures, built across rivers, serve a dual purpose. They regulate the flow of water, storing excess volumes during periods of heavy rainfall, and gradually release it. This careful regulation of river levels reduces the risk of downstream flooding. Canals are the detours of the water world. Canals divert excess river water away from populated or vulnerable areas. They direct it to regions where floods pose less of a risk or into storage basins. The next strategy focuses on floodplain management. It involves restricting development in flood-prone areas. By doing so, it reduces potential damage and maintains the natural flood-absorbing capacity of these regions, providing a buffer zone between human settlements and potential floods. Urban green spaces, including parks, gardens, and green roofs, offer another solution. These spaces absorb rainwater, reducing runoff and enhancing the resilience of urban areas to flooding. They also provide the added benefit of beautifying our cities. Improved land use planning is another crucial strategy. This involves implementing zoning laws that encourage sustainable development and minimize impermeable surfaces in urban areas. This facilitates better water absorption and drainage. reducing the likelihood of flooding. Flood management strategies ranging from dams and reservoirs to early warning systems play a vital role in safeguarding our communities and preserving our environment. We can turn the tide. Innovations in environmental engineering are showing us how. It's not just about high-tech solutions, it's about how you can make a difference. Whether it's by supporting local green initiatives or advocating for sustainable urban policies. Okay, see you next time, unless we all decided to evolve into mermaids, which frankly, I'm not ruling out.